Hi, this is rickysun. I'm a Pi consultant. In this video, I'm going to talk about DataBricks on the cloud. So what is DataBricks? Just to share with you some experience that I have. I don't have a lot of experience, but here's my impression of DataBricks. It is a SaaS, right? You create that with DataBricks services cloud, and when you run it, it costs you some money by the resources you pick, right? Depends on how fast it is and the time you run it. Let's say you have code that is needed to run on the cloud, that like maybe block of code that you created is not going to utilize all the resources you need from the DataBricks, but you are still paying the DataBricks resources because at this one, you are taking up the resources from Microsoft, right? So they charge you for it. I think it really depends on how much code you have, right? How many applications you have to be run on DataBricks. If the more, the better, right? Try to utilize all the resources you created and not, instead of just letting it, the DataBricks run, and then you just have just utilize it 1%, if that makes sense, right? The reason why I'm talking about that is I have a project for my teammate. I give it to him, right? His task is to upload the logs files, right? The log of analytics, right? In a machine that connect to the cloud, PiAF analytics, right? We want to monitor the analytics log in order to proactively make sure it is working all the time, right? When there's problem, we want to know quicker and react to it. That's like the first task, right? Upload the log files to the Azure data lake, right? Because DataBricks can look at Azure data lake. So periodically we upload the logs to the Azure data lake, right? And then DataBricks look at Azure data lake to start running the program, right? That's kind of like what's going on. And why are we taking the logs, right? Taking the logs so that we can parse the logs only to the point on what we wanted to see. Like, for example, has some useless information, to put it this way. And our goal is to know the errors that are important, right? Not all the errors are important too, so we know what errors could look like that we need attention. So we're going to parse the logs and only output it to a CSV files that we want to see, like constantly the code manipulating the logs information, if that makes sense. So everything go into the memory of DataBricks, and we use Python code to parse the logs. And you know, DataBricks is very cool in a way because it's called notebook, and it lets you execute chunk of code at a time. You can do one line of code too, right? And then you, when you run it, you see the result. And then from the result, okay, now I am going to write another line of code to manipulate that next step. You can look at all the process as the data get transformed, if that makes sense, right? And then at the end of the day, when you are comfortable building your code, everything runs, right? You can just press the run all button and then everything execute at once, right? Instead of doing one chunk at a time. Somebody said it's like Jupyter Notebook as well, and I kind of agree to it, right? Jupyter Notebook, you can run a chunk at a time as well, right? DataBricks is doing the same thing. We can parse the log, we can see the output, right? What is important at the end of the day. And my teammate has delivered, right? He told me what it is and he had done his task, able to filter everything out. And then the result is what we want to see. From the one file, if we look at this file, when there's things inside that file, that means analytics is having a problem. So that's, he got that project done, and then I go back to him and ask him, hey, why are we using DataBricks? It can do what you just said. And my other question is, can we use other technology to do the same thing? And like, actually, I answer my own question. That moment is like, yes, because we can write a .NET application on the servers and run the code, take the log file in, parse it, send email to yourself when there is error in the logs that needs your attention, right? So why use DataBricks? I don't know. He actually mentioned it's cool to do. You know, it's amazing. Never exposed to this kind of technology, but there's a chance for me to expose to that new technology, right? Like, it's cool. What he told me is kind of like very good. You have a Ferrari, you just drive two blocks away and then you go to your neighbors. It's cool to do, especially you want to attract ladies, I think. Is it reasonable to do it? No. Is it excessive to do it? Probably, right? Why you you can be walking, right? You could be walking, not driving a Ferrari. It's expensive to do too, right? Like as I said, to run DataBricks continuously monitoring some log file, you need to run it like 24 hours per day. One piece of code, it's like utilizing 1% of, or maybe less, of the resources of the DataBricks. Let's say I have 100 applications running simultaneously, continuously using DataBricks, and I got code for that, it might be reasonable, right? You have to utilize DataBricks to a certain point in order to use it, I think. Like, otherwise it's just a waste of resources. You have to turn it on for one application, and you might as well run like 100 applications on the same DataBricks, right? And it charges you as it run, right? The DataBricks run, not the code run. So it's very excessive. But I agree, right? It's like Ferrari going to the neighbor. It's very cool to do, right? I think my teammate very happy that he got a project like that, and well, it spent us a little bit of money. I mean, maybe in total 50 or something, but like for just to test, right? To see what we can do with DataBricks, right? That's kind of like research project, and see, okay, from the Pi administrator or the consulting standpoint, right? Like, can we utilize it and take it to our advantage, right? I mentioned about Azure Data Factory. That one actually makes sense, and it is cheap too. Azure Data Factory actually costs way less than DataBricks to me, and it brilliant jobs of improving the performance of table lookup from the AF standpoint. So is it worth it? Well, if you have a lot of money burning, run DataBricks. Otherwise, no. That's kind of like what I like to share. I'm curious, what do you do with DataBricks, right? Do you have application running with DataBricks against some sort of related application to the pisystem, right? Yeah, I would like to hear your opinions about that. Like, to me, it's cool, doesn't mean we have to use it, right? I won't use it. I think like that's the end of the DataBricks project, but we know DataBricks a little bit. The learning curve actually is not that bad. It's pretty easy to use. I would say it doesn't take too much time for a developer to get a hand on it, right? I don't see an application that needs DataBricks for us, for an app like a Pi consultant or Pi administrator so far. And anything related to Pi, maybe there's something else that can replace it instead of using DataBricks, right? Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. I'll see you next week. Bye.